Liberty and justice. actually discussed, there's two meetings of the Parking Rec Commission this month, August 4th and 25th and 16th, and our community in the park. And also, music in the park is a pretty good bit, they can tell you this year, so we'll meet again next week at that, and that's about it. So those are all state committee reports, and again, now with our official reports, and we start with the mayor, Kim.
Good evening, I want to welcome everyone here tonight, and if you've had a chance to participate in National Night Out, I think you've probably enjoyed yourself very much, and if you had a chance to go to the Food Truck Fest over the weekend, I hope you found it very enjoyable. Just like to ask council's consideration of ordinances 68, 79, and 82, thank you.
Next, we have our city attorney, Mr. Michael Good.
Thank you, Mr. President, members of council, and thank you also, public, for coming out this evening. I am pleased to report July numbers from Mayor's Court. We had approximately 223 active cases that went through Mayor's Court, those are random cases. It is interesting, once again, that we are still tracking around the 25 percentile of actual Whitehall residents, but I do have a very interesting number that I was able to look at in the past trend for the past 7 months. When we're looking at criminal cases through our Whitehall Mayor's Court, criminal cases being possession of marijuana, theft, domestic violence, even assault, Whitehall residents, we're tracking at around 8 to 9%. So if you want to tell everyone in the community that you're listening to me right now, and I've got the numbers and I've got the data to support it, Whitehall's a safe place. Safe place to live, safe place to raise your family. And that is one of the things that I'm noticing with the mayor's court. So I'm really encouraged by what I'm seeing, and I will have a report next month with respect to the August numbers. The next thing from the city attorney's office, I would like to publicly thank Whitehall City Schools. Board member Joy Devins is here in the audience tonight, along with Tracy Taylor, who has collaborated with the city attorney's office to create a free community workshop entitled Fight Back, Safety, Stalking, and Domestic Violence. The purpose of this seminar, this workshop, is to give hands-on, practical knowledge on how to protect yourself and how to arm yourself with information so that you are not a victim, so that you can empower yourself with that information. The panel itself, I'm pleased to announce, we've got Judge Laurel Beatty will be on the council. She will be on the panel speaking. I have members from our prosecutor's office that will be there, as well as a domestic violence advocate for my office that will also be there. The greatest thing that I'm tickled to announce is that we have our own public safety council member, Lee Staley, who will be the moderator for this event. And I'm so excited to have him be the moderator as long as you all know him to be inquisitive. So people ask some great questions, but it's meant to be interactive. So come if you decide to come. Come with your questions, and they will get answered, and you will get the information necessary so you will not be a victim, and you will know how to fight back against anything that will come your way. Now, unofficially, I'd like to welcome back my daughter, Michaela, who's back from her summer seminar, as well as announce that my son is running a quarterback scheme for the Whitehall Rams. He might be the fifth or sixth string, but he's running.
Thank you.
country court for March 2016. The division of police bringing paper court for June 2016. And the remarriage report to council for June 2016. And communication positions and claims, there are no items listed on the agendas that you have. However, since the agenda was prepared, we have received the following items. The first is the agenda for the August 4, 2016 meeting of the Whitehall Parks and Recreation Commission. And we also received the minutes of the June 23rd, 2016 meeting of the Whitehall Parks and Recreation Commission. That's all we have under communication positions and claims. We will now move on to our public hearings for the evening. And we'll begin with Ordinance 64-2016, amending the zoning map, attached to Chapter 1122 of the 1970 codified ordinances of the City of Whitehall, Ohio, and as subsequently amended, allowing a special permit under 1123.08C29 to allow a Child's Journey, LLC, to operate a daycare on the property located at 846 South Irving Road, owned by Deer Enterprises, LLC. So I'll open that hearing at this time, and for anyone who would like to speak in favor of this ordinance, please step forward. State your name and address for the record.
Thank you. Thank you. that we had talked about. I was able to meet with Mr. Ryan earlier in the week, you know, over the as we touched on earlier with the fencing and clearing of the shrubs. According to the site plan, we will be removing those, the electrical fence, but the site plan is underway. We had an interior blueprints that would be submitted as far as after the main process goes with it. And then we'll have the additional site plan for that. We will straighten and seal the lot. One of the things was the trash cans and where to put those in the dumpster location. What we ended up with, we were able to get cleared for totes on the side, so we'll make an enclosure for the toters. We'll do two for the day here, one for the existing business that's there, fence to actually playground fence on that. Restriping the asphalt is no problem. The final landscape plan will get in. The other thing is the monument sign. That is something that I did not originally have in the budget. We discussed getting through it, getting the build out done, and then with approval, having that installed by the springtime, just so we can help cover those spots for the. And then we'll be submitting the interior plan that applies all codes. We do have experience, and we've done charter school build-up for a series of charter schools around town that we have as a client. We've done a lot of work for them. My boss, the owner of the company, also happens to be the son of the property owner, has 25 years management and build-out experience in about that experience. So we're very confident with their help and with our network of subcontractors getting through this, doing it properly, safely, and building.
Okay, on the coast, they're located right next to the county. Is that where they will be picked up from by the fire service?
Yes.
Okay, so they're not going to be going out.
I talked to local waste rep and then out there. The truck actually stopped on your lane. The guys will run out, grab the tow, put it back in the truck. That is for very current department on the line. I think three of those are each.
All right, so they will be picked up from the sporting area.
Correct.
So they're not going to be typically, you know, on Tuesday night in the Red Coast or
right.
In a particular case,
right, they will go run out of it, even though they're large department stock trailer.
So, but they will be, the truck will be talking to you about, I'm sure there's other questions on the other
side. And the residents, yeah, also, so, yeah,
that's no difference than it would be correct.
Correct.
For the toter, for the private sale, I want to say
it's 4 feet, which is what the
so what is 6 foot fence on the south border?
I mean, yeah.
Well, then that would
be the east side, and then the fence right there, the south,
yeah. South,
but the
right. No, it's here, so it's the fence on the south side, so there's a 6 foot fence.
That can be done there because of the alley, but it does not have to be
done. Yeah, I need to do that.
There might be a good job.
So the only part that will be fenced will actually be the play area.
Correct.
So the fence, correct, not going to continue around the parking lot now to.
Correct. Yeah, the separate play area will be a separate fence around the toter. Screen them from a view from the year when you drive along.
Just for clarification, thank you.
Other question. The fence is not going to cover the entire stretch of
to prevent somebody from coming in there.
It's so that it will be down the whole east part of that house, but we'll kind of help shape to have that address area. They're 30 inches wide, but the gentleman that we're supposed to have a factory is not.
They're on the wheel.
Well, I should do it.
Yeah, I'm just back. Child Journey LLC to operate a daycare
provisions in the planning commission. Something or another. I can't think of what to say there. To include the recommendations of the planning commission, I mean, and to include, to make sure that it includes the six foot.
And straight.
And straight.
Around the present.
So I have to just call it.
Yes. Here.
Yes.
Here.
Yes.
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 Yes. Well, order 64-2016 has been passed as amended. Congratulations.
Welcome.
Property owned by four black. by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Bailey, for introduction and suspension of all rules on ordinance 78.16, question and comment. Ms. Frymark, please call the roll.
Coniston?
Yes.
Tanner?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Morrison?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Gray?
Yes.
Rules have been suspended on ordinance 78.16, question and comment. Motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Bailey, for adoption of ordinance 78.16, Ms. Frymark, please call the roll.
Coniston?
Yes.
Tanner?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Morrison?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Gray?
Yes.
Ordinance 78.16 has been adopted. Next we have ordinance 79.16. Authorizing and approving a supplemental appropriation of $200,000 for appropriated monies in the general fund to the transfer expense account, authorizing and approving an expense account. Let me start over. There's too many and no comments. Authorizing and approving a supplemental appropriation of $200,000 from unappropriated monies in the general fund to the transfer expense account, authorizing and approving a transfer in the amount of $200,000 from the transfer expense account, to the capital improvements fund, authorizing and approving a supplemental appropriation in the amount of $200,000 from the 311 capital improvements fund to the capital improvements expense account, and declaring an emergency.
Mr. President, I'd like to introduce ordinance 79 and move for suspension of all rules.
Second. A motion by Mr. Bailey. Thank God. And a second by Mr. Gray. Again, for introduction and suspension of all rules on ordinance 79-2016, questions or comments? I have a very difficult to read without comments. All right. Ms. Frymark, please call the roll.
Coniston?
Yes.
Tanner?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Coniston?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Gray?
Yes.
Rules have been suspended on ordinance 79-2016.
Move to adopt.
Second. Motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Gray, for adoption of ordinance 79-2016. Ms. Frymark, please call the roll.
Coniston?
Yes.
Tanner?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Morrison?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Gray?
Yes.
Ordinance 79-2016 has been adopted. I'm not used to it in the first year. Gray, that's why he hesitated. All right, so next we have ordinance 80-2016. It's amended the zoning map attached to chapter 1122 of the 1970 codified ordinances of the city of Whitehall, Ohio, and are subsequently amended, allowing a special permit under 1123.12C5 to allow Bed Magic USA LLC to operate a bankless dent removal facility on property located at 171C and 171B North Appleton Road, property owned by HGI Midwest LLC. That's being read by title only. It's been referred to the Planning Commission, and we also have a public hearing set for that piece of legislation on September 6, 2016. Next, we have ordinance 81-2016. It's approving and making a supplemental appropriation of $109,000 from previously unappropriated monies in the accrued benefits reserve fund to the accrued benefits reserve expense account, and declaring an emergency.
So, I'd introduce ordinance 81-2016 for suspension of rules.
Second. Motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Morrison for introduction and suspension of rules on ordinance 81-2016. Questions or comments? Ms. Frymark, please call the roll.
Coniston?
Yes.
Tanner?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Morrison?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Gray?
Yes.
The rules have been suspended on ordinance 81-2016.
Second.
Motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Morrison for adoption of ordinance
Reinhardt, please call the roll.
Johnson? Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Johnson?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Rules have been suspended on the table 2.16.
Put up.
Second. First by Mr. Shea, second by Mr. Tanner for adoption of the ordinance 82-2016. Ms. Reinhardt, please call the roll.
Johnson? Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Morrison?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Ordinance 82-2016 has been adopted. Next is resolution 2040. Resolution 45-2016. Resolving to approve that announcement 56 and declaring an emergency. This president, I think, is resolution 45-2016. Second. Motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Rodriguez for introduction and suspension of all rules on resolution 45-2016. Question or comment?
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Morrison?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Rules have been suspended on resolution 45-2016. Move to adopt. Second. Motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Rodriguez for adoption of resolution 45-2016. Ms. Reinhardt, please call the roll.
Johnson? Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Morrison?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Resolution 45-2016 has been adopted. Next, we have resolution 46-2016. Resolving to approve that announced certificates and declaring an emergency. This president, I introduce resolution 46-2016.
Second.
Motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Johnson for introduction and suspension of all rules. Resolution 46-2016, questions or comments? For those new people, if there are some out there, I believe there may be one or two, that announced certificates are basically bills that we get for services that have already been performed, and we're required to pay those for a certain amount of time, and that's why these pieces of legislation like this are available for free. This is a 30-day deal, and in order to get pay on time, we have to look at the worst opportunity we have. So, motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Johnson for introduction and suspension of rules. Ms. Reinhardt, please call the roll.
Johnson? Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Johnson?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
All right. The rules have been suspended on resolution 46-2016.
Second.
Motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Ms. Johnson for adoption of resolution 46-2016. Ms. Reinhardt, please call the roll.
Johnson? Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Morrison?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Resolution 46-2016 has been adopted. Next, we have resolution 47-2016. Resolving to approve then announce certificates and declaring an emergency. Mr. President, I think the ordinance 47-2016 is the suspension of rules. Second. The motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Gray for introduction and suspension of rules on resolution 47-2016. Questions or comments? Ms. Reinhardt, please call the roll.
Johnson? Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Morrison?
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Right?
Yes. The rules have been suspended on resolution 47-2016. Move to adopt. Second. Motion by Mr. Bailey, second by Mr. Gray for adoption of resolution 47-2016. Ms. Reinhardt, please call the roll.
Johnson? Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
Bailey?
Yes. Yes.
Bailey?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Resolution 47-2016 has been adopted. This is the last item we have under ordinance
Do you know how many margaritas they drink that day?
I'm still thinking the cost savings would be tremendous. I turned down a little for to Michelle and she didn't seem to have any idea. So apparently that is off the table now. So, but thank everyone for coming out to see you next time.
Yes,
Mr.
Taylor. Thank you, Mr. President. I'd also like to thank everybody for coming. The school board member here told that he's had as much 15 people.
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Gray?
Yes.
All right, we are adjourned. Hope to see you all here at the next meeting. Thank you for coming.
I said, and you.
They hasn't first. No, I say later. Hi, John. That's all, sir. Thank you. Hey, how you doing, Bob? Bob is Dale. How are you?
I do want to put it down.
I'm not going to vote.
There are three little things you've got to play.